This afternoon, I want to share the journey, the highs and the lows, the near disasters and the huge successes. And since we almost hear the bells of another year over, as crazy as it is, it's an opportunity for me to pass on some of my experience in planning the best festive celebrations a company can have. And if you want the wow factor, then obviously we're the team to call. So where, how and what? Well, I've dined twice at Buckingham Palace and sat next to Prince Andrew as his guest. I've dined twice at St James's Palace with Prince Charles. I've attended the Royal Garden Party in my role as an ambassador for the Prince's Trust, where the Queen and I had the same Philip Treacy hat on. Embarrassed I was not. November 2015, I was invited to have Thanksgiving dinner with Robbie and Ida Williams at their London home, where dinner guests included Adele and Nicole Scherzinger. Needless to say, I haven't eaten since. I had a day shopping in Milan with Ida, a challenge for any Amex card, followed by dinner that same evening with Ant and Dec. My journey has cultivated professional relationships with some of the country's leading sports stars, actors, musicians, and TV personalities. I am their event planner, their entertainment specialist. I become their confidant and invariably a psychologist. So what's the big secret to working successfully with a wealth of discerning celebrities, high-flying stars, and one or two creative divas, of which some say I am one? Let me tell you a little bit. If you're on Twitter, you may know me as Party Magnet. And if you tuned into Channel 4, I'm the Millionaire Party Planner. If you keep up with TLC, you'll know me as Queen Bee. However, today, I am Liz Taylor, carbon sugar-free girl and founder of the Taylor Link Corporation since 1984. With our headquarters in Manchester, the company produces private parties, weddings and corporate events from all over the world, from Saint-Tropez to Istanbul, Marrakesh, New York, Venice, Moscow, to name but a few. And along the way, we've earned a formidable reputation that has secured the brand a top position amongst our competitors. I thrive on the daily challenge of creating and delivering the impossible, and we are the vital ingredient in any successful event. In the corporate market, some firms that have been treated to the TLC factor are ITV Granada with its Coronation Street brand, Manchester United, Louis Vuitton Watch and Jewellery, Roche, BGL, which is Budget Insurance, Regatta, and BM Bargains, just to name a few. Our organisation extends to recognition events, award ceremonies, gala celebrations, outdoor activities, conferences. Wherever or whenever you need to showcase your business brand, TLC is on it. What is the difference with our events and other event companies, you may ask? Well, three words: brand is key. After a privileged education at Manchester High School, I left at 18 and joined the management training scheme at Marks and Spencer's. And as a trainee, I learned that administration and organisation was key. However, I knew I was well prepared for the role when I saw a school report that said Elizabeth, age 4, would do better if she wasn't so bossy. I progressed into retail management for 8 years and at 26 was running the retail shops and concessions for Sterling Cooper. Some of you may be too young to remember, so if you weren't around, Google it. Their brand was very cool. When I became pregnant with my elder daughter, Goldie, in early 1984, I gave up work and I attached myself to a privately owned designer shop who needed PR. At the same time, a friend of mine was organising a party and asked for my help. It was themed, and she invested in set designers and production teams, which I sourced for her. And during my prenatal food fests, she encouraged me to consider doing it for a living. Personal circumstances and two young girls with 40 months apart pushed me into focusing on my future. A divorcee of a 2- and 4-year-old gave me the confidence and hunger to seize an opportunity. The Holiday Inn took over the iconic Midland Hotel in 1997, and a chance meeting led me to organise a Hollywood night for Northwest PA groups. You see, they were around then. And it was such a success that the hotel handed me 3 further projects. So with £200 in the bank, I formed Liz Taylor Associates, and that gut instinct has influenced all my decisions in my life. In 1992, I was approached to join the board of a well-established London events company. My role as a single mum with no other means of support encouraged me to accept. At the time, it offered me the security of a salary. However, things were to dramatically change. In 1996, the IRA bombed Manchester and the rejuvenation plans changed the commercial and retail perspective of the city. The investment after this tragedy was huge. And during a conversation with a key supplier, Diane Lynn, of the Taylor Lynn, it was decided that she and I would join forces and set up in business together. Back on my own in 1995, the Taylor Lynn Corporation was born, bringing with it the combined talents of Springbank Flowers, owned then by Diane, and my 9 years of experience in the industry. Granada Studios Tour was on the drawing board. City Centre hotels were employing events personnel, and I secured myself as preferred supplier at every single venue possible. I was committed to delivering a first-class product, quality-driven, not necessarily price-driven, consistent, innovative, and surrounded myself with a team of trusted people. This combination contributed to its rapid success, and someone once told me, to be successful, you had to build a brand. So when Diane and I started making chair covers and tablecloths for our events, we realised there was a market for hire, and so we formed the Table Linen Company, another TLC. Shortly after this, we took our two key production guys and set up the Total Lighting Company, which was based in Yorkshire. Overflowing with enthusiasm, we pooled our profits and bought a large industrial site in Old Trafford. A slight euphemism, it was Trotter's Yard, but it was 6,000 square foot that worked perfectly for the flower business and the event empire. We then secured another large site directly behind, put Table Linen in there, and now, property magnates, we had the foundation to grow. Moving on with a host of successful events under my belt, Diane ran the floristry, I ran the events, I would create Narnia, she would deliver it. We were a force to be reckoned with, and we turned fantasy into reality. We had the most challenging and successful 15 years together. Then in 2008, I bought Diane out. There is never an amicable divorce, as some of us know too well, but this was a huge decision on my part. The timing was right for us both, and for me to continue to grow, we had to part company. We sold the Table Linen Company for a nice profit, retaining the new buyers as tenants, and we folded the production company. This allowed me to focus entirely on what I loved and what I had built, which was the events company. The product. There is no rehearsal and there is no room for error. It's a one night only and you are responsible for every element of that occasion. The theatre, the drama, the exclusivity, the wow, the staff toilets, the skips, the power supply, the list goes on and on. The 6 a.m. starts and the 3 a.m. finishes. Clearing up all the mess after everyone has gone, the health and safety restrictions that come with venues, the backup generators that are lined up in case one fails, is a unique operation that we run with military precision. So when Channel 4 asked to come in for a glimpse, I was quite excited to show viewers, of which 1.5 million watched, what we do. As you all saw, some of you saw, I had no editorial rights. If I had done, It would have been the emoji scene and not the limousine scene that was shown. But what it did do was demonstrate that there is a serious side to this industry. It's a business with crazy budgets at our fingertips. We had 8,000 website hits within 48 hours and we had 10.1 million tweets. One of them was, she should get a better plastic surgeon. That is true. What? I don't agree. And I'm still amazed at how many people recognise us as a result of the show. It's been repeated 4 or 5 times, including Ireland just a few weeks ago, and has just been commissioned to show in Israel next month. The power of social media is off the scale, as we all know. Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, Snapchat, we can communicate all over the world in an instant. Biannual social media training at HQ is obligatory for all of us, and my staff send me on anger management courses when necessary, a fair exchange. It's actually my PA who sends me on anger management. I never set out to run a company focusing solely on celebrity clients. In fact, half of TLC's work is in the corporate industry and celebrations for discerning, but non-celebrity. The other half of our work, we've generated a little black book of people that other event companies would kill for. Lucky perhaps, but also hard-earned through creating a reputation for delivering the best. Our confidentiality on our endless wealth of creativity. I can look back on key opportunities that led me to celebrity planner status, a road which resulted in some fabulous events and where I've made some great friends. And just to give you a couple of examples, Monday morning I'm driving to work, head focused on the week away, and the mobile phone rings in the car. Heads up, Liz, I've given your number to Peter Kay. His wife's going to be 40. A good call, because if someone phones you on Monday morning and says it's Peter Kay here, I couldn't be responsible for the expletives that he would have got at the other end. Needless to say, he did call. One of my very favourite tales is the call that I got from an anonymous lady who advised me that she'd been recommended to me and was coming up to Manchester the following day. She wouldn't arrange to meet me, but she was checking if I was in town. For some reason, I hadn't asked her name, but we were deep in conversation. There was just something about this call that made me sit up. After chipping through the barrier with Queen Bee charm, I established she was looking to stay at a local hotel, Great John Street, and her first appointment was at the Hilton. But she said Great John Street was full. It was my opportunity. I said, give me your number and give me 5 minutes, I'll call you back. I still didn't have a name. I phoned up my mate Tiffany at Great John Street, and I secured her complimentary accommodation on the proviso that she let me meet her at the Hilton Hotel the following morning, and it was a deal. She was Gary Barlow's PA, and the rest is history. 3 events later for the captain himself, X Factor closing party with Harry Styles behind the bar, Sharon Osbourne comparing notes with me about the North and Manchester South Manchester divide, and then some 12 months later, I'm ironing Howard Donald's shirt for his wedding in Oxford while he reads me his speech. This association led to an introduction to Robbie, whose wife was sporting a Goyard handbag. Fresh back from LA, where I had purchased one myself, we were firm friends within minutes, and we remain so. A world of glamour, great for the CV, and lots of fun. But no more or less important than the person who has £1,000 to spare and needs a little bit of TLC, because someone at her party will be my next big job. And so it goes on. People always panic at weekends, so Mondays are the most exciting of days for me. Another such morning, and this is the conversation. I've been recommended to you as the go-to event planner. I have an event in 3 weeks which is falling apart. Can you please be at Kensington Palace tomorrow for 10:30? Yeah, you know, you roll your eyes. I'm organising it on behalf of Centrepoint. Sure, I said, what's Centrepoint? It's a charity and the patrons are the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge. Oh, okay, I say, so who's the client? They are. Do you have entertainment booked? Yes, we do. We have Taylor Swift and John Bon Jovi. So what's the first thing a girl does? She hotfoots it to the hairdressers and books an early train into London. When we organised the wedding of Mark Wright and Michelle Keegan, brought in 3 months before because their wedding planner had proved to be a disaster, the finite timing and restrictions put upon us were huge, as it was covered by OK Magazine. It was and is, after all, a business transaction. I cannot disclose their fee, but it was 6 figures. And that is a huge responsibility for us, whilst making sure that Michelle has her dream day. Our skills are not only in the design that must always reflect the client, but also the logistics and the security that comes with these magazine deals. And whether it's a celebrity wedding, celebrity charity event, or private profile, in order to demonstrate just what we do, and with no knowledge as to which shots they will publish, is a very, very stressful experience. But the secret to the success is that each event is unique. I take each one a blank canvas and create a production that has never been seen before. We don't repeat. When it comes to planning a Christmas event, it's always a particularly special challenge. And you can't take Christmas out of Christmas. So how do you make it different? Well, first of all, apologies for this, but you never go home saying you had a great piece of chicken. You go home saying, oh my God, I had the best night. The drinks were amazing. The band were fantastic. What did you eat? I don't know. I can't remember. I was so pissed. I can't remember. But it was fine. So alcohol, for a corporate event, the free bar is key. It's very important. A lot of people judge, and even if some companies ask them to contribute £5 or £10 to charity, they always have the hump if the bar is not free. So come up with a cocktail. We design cocktails that look amazing and don't cost a lot. We did one for a circus event, and it was a plastic bag from Sainsbury's filled with vodka and tonic, little orange plastic goldfish and a straw. And that was our one that we served on our carousel bar. So you can be really innovative with the booze, and it's presented in such a way and everybody's happy. The food is key, but it doesn't have to be a sit-down meal. The Christmas markets are out there, so go out and bring them inside. You know, bring the hot dog stall, the burger stall, the fish and chip stall, chestnuts. Bring everything in. And that's what we've done quite a few times in venues, in spaces, empty spaces, that we've been able to hire for 1,000 people and just bring loads of stalls in. Just think a little bit out of the box, what you actually do want from it and not what you feel that you have to give to it. And style is simple. Christmas is Christmas, so don't change it, because I think traditional is cool. And you can do lots of things with Blackwatch tartan, red tartan, mistletoe, all sorts of stuff. Are they all a complete success? Yes, they are. But behind every success, obviously, there are one or two potential disasters. And I have two that really have stayed with me for a long time. One of them was a Jewish wedding that we did in Manchester on a Sunday. And none of us in the office picked up it was Remembrance Sunday. So we have a band that flies in from Paris, 17-piece band, and the truck comes in the night before with all the equipment and all the artists' clothes on, and it parks itself in St. Peter's Square. So needless to say, the following morning, on the Sunday morning, the van's not there. It took me 8 hours, and I ended up at Bootle Street Police Station sobbing to the sergeant, because the privately owned company that had removed the van were not interested in any at all in letting this van out of the compound. And I had no backup plan. Eventually, the sergeant at Bootle Street came out and he said, I've got your van, but it's going to cost you £750. I said, I would have paid £7,500 to get that van out of the thing. So we get the van, the band get on stage, they do the rehearsal, the ceremony's at 4 o'clock, I run up to the synagogue, and just as she's going down the aisle to show my face, the mother turns around and she went, is everything all right? And a lesson well learnt. And my other one is Moscow. We went out there to do the Champions League final for Manchester United, and it was a huge event. And they were playing Chelsea. So obviously it was Abramovich, and it was his country. And we sent out, we had 22 crew, we had £20,000 worth of flowers from Holland. We had a whole plane load of set stuff. We were building tables, bars, everything for a party that was going to start at 1 o'clock in the morning. And they held it at customs. And they held it for 3 days, and I didn't sleep. I had a bum bag of cash. I bribed anyone that would take a bribe from me. And eventually, on the Wednesday, at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, kickoff was at 9 o'clock, eventually they allowed me to have the stuff. They won, they played extra time, they didn't get back to the hotel till 3 in the morning. We were ready, as were the band from Paris, and they partied till 9:30. We missed the freight home. It cost £36,000 to get the gear back to the UK, and I flew back with the team, and never, ever again. Not for any money. And so as the curtain closes and the lights are about to go down on my presentation, I want to be clear. Challenging, fun, exciting, inspiring, exhausting, but I wouldn't change anything. I've had the most amazing 30 years. I represented the UK 2 years ago at an event planning conference in Mauritius, all expenses, business class flights, and a villa on the beach with a butler I managed. As a result, I've been invited to Dubai in October to do the same to a smaller group of distinguished invitees only. On this occasion, I have been asked to host 2 seminars, and I'm staying in the Palazzo Versace, so life does have its perks. My journey's opened up very exciting opportunities for me. One is a consultancy agreement that I've accepted, advising a client of mine who has bought Lone Star, which is the best restaurant, indeed only one situated on the beach in Barbados. For those of you who know the island, you'll agree it's the place to dine. For those of you who don't, Google it. I'm back and forth implementing the attention to detail that has awarded me that Rottweiler reputation, and I'm loving the new challenge. This has now extended to a property in Jersey and glorious Wigan, and it's a whole new string to my bow. I've recently got my feet well under the table at Liverpool FC, and next year is their 125-year anniversary. And having just produced the Player of the Year awards, I'm confident and secure in the knowledge that we will continue to be a key supplier to the club. And it's those relationships which continue to build my business. Last week, as a result of a few appearances on This Morning, you'll be seeing a little bit more of me with my great mates Eamon and Ruth when I divulge on air some top secrets on how to dress the table for numerous festivities. However, there is never one day that I'm complacent. If I'm non-stop for 6 months, I only worry about the day that I'm not busy. When people say, what do you do in the day? I can't even answer because every day is different. Gary Neville can call me to meet for lunch. Mrs. Jo Bloggs can call because her daughter's going to be 21. And then my younger daughter, who's married and living in New York, calls because she needs a loan. That's life, and I wouldn't swap mine for anything. So thank you very much. Now, this is the embarrassing bit where you have to do a Q&A. So somebody's got to ask me a question, otherwise I'm just stood.
Hi, I'm Skevy, I'm from KPMG. If you could go back to yourself when you were younger, what advice would you, like looking at yourself now, what advice would you give yourself starting out, or are you happy with how things have turned out?
Well, I always wanted to do law. I did want to do law, and I just fell into this because I hated school and I realised I was never going to go to university. I would have done some things differently, but I think that every experience you have contributes to what you learn in life. So, yeah, I mean, I wouldn't have married my ex-husband, but, you know, what? Got two children, so... No, I wouldn't have done anything differently. The only thing I would say, and I've said this before to a number of people, you know, if you've got a goal or you've got a bucket list, just do it. If your gut instinct's there, just take the risk, because now's the time to do it. You know, you're young and seize every opportunity. What's the worst that can happen? You fail.
What advice would you give us for planning a Christmas event on a budget of £35 per head?
I was just going to say 0161876666 until he said the budget. I think if you came to me with that, I would source a really cool, unusual venue that possibly was prepared to do some sort of contra for some exposure, and put that £35 a head literally into a really great DJ and a bar and your fish and chip van. I think, you know, I hate these dinners where you have to... where you go to a Christmas party night, you know, and it's £35 a head, and you're irrelevant, you're invisible, and it's all just so ugh, and it's samey. And that would be my advice. Phone me when you've got it up to 50.
When it comes to your own private and family functions, who do you go to? Do you do that yourself, or would you put that out to your own team?
Well, I've made two weddings and for both my daughters, which, you know, I started off with this great enthusiasm and obviously nervous because I knew that they had to be sort of showcase what I did. But I organised a big birthday party for myself, but I hate them. I hate them because you can't enjoy it and you can't be objective. And also, I won't let anybody else do it. So as much as the staff, you know, were on board, the files were this thick and, you know, they all used to groan. When my second daughter got engaged, I saw the eyes were on, thought, oh, no, here we go again. It's hard because it's all about delegation. And if I could delegate, I don't think I'd be as good as I am at what I do, because you guys, if you hopefully phone up or follow up, you want to speak to myself. So ultimately, I don't go to anybody. And they're both married and they're not having second weddings.
Miss Taylor, can I ask a question, please? Just wondered if my name's Rory. I've been working here. I had the pleasure of working here for the last 6 months, but it's not what I only do. I'm actually trained as an actor and a singer, and I just wondered if you give people the chance to, perform for your company. It would be wonderful if we had the opportunity to do something like that, to actually sing to you. Fronti a te, o sole mio, stan fronti a te, stan fronti a te. Thank you very much indeed, thank you. O sole mio, stan fronti a te. Big note coming. Stan fronti a te. I'm allowed one more song. Can it not be the next one, the next one after that? Because I'd love it if everyone joined in. Thank you very much, Chris. This can't take my eyes off you. I think it's that one. If you've got that on the track list, thank you very much.
I love you, baby, and if it's quite all right, I need you, baby, to warm the lonely night. I love you, baby, trust in me when I say. Oh, pretty baby, don't let me down, I pray. Oh, pretty baby, you're doing a close-up. And let me love you, baby, let me love you. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. Liz Taylor's too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. You know what to do now, ladies and gentlemen. Na 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 na. I love you, baby, and if it's quite alright, I need you, baby, to warm the lonely night. I love you, baby. Trust in me when I say. Oh, pretty baby, don't let me down, I pray. Oh, pretty baby, now that I've found you, stay and let me love. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. God bless you, Liz. Thank you. Bye.